Holy that was amazing. Oh my god.
Yeah, check out the video, but I don't even know how to call that.
So I'm in a place and it probably has the highest concentration of street arts in Europe.
This place represents freedom.
Hello YouTube, this is Michael here. I just arrived in Poland and I'm now in a city called Gdansk in the northern part of Poland. I only have about 30 hours here, but I'm sure I'll have a great time because these are the top 5 reasons why you should visit Gdansk, but not as a tourist. So let's go.
Number 1, Stocksinia. So this is Gdansk Shipyard. Nowadays it's called Gdansk Shipyard, but back when Poland was under the Soviet Union's control, it was actually called the Lenin Shipyard. Back in the 1960s and the 1970s, Poland, just like a lot of countries under the Soviet Union, they were in a bad shape, both politically and economically. There were a lot of attempts to start strikes and protests here in Poland, but they were all put down to rest by force. Because communism, let's face it, that's dictatorship. Until one day in the 1980s, everything changed. In 1980, the workers in this shipyard said, "We've had enough." So they went on strike and they took over control of this entire shipyard. They started a series of discussions with the government and this led to fundamental changes in the system. And 11 years later, the Soviet Union collapsed.
So this place represents freedom.
There's also a museum here, this one, the European Solidarity Center. But unfortunately, because of COVID, it's temporarily closed. But they have a lot of very useful information about the history here. So if you come here after COVID, definitely worth a visit to come to this European Solidarity Center.
I am a true believer of liberty and the personal freedom. So this place right here is very symbolic for me. And to be honest, it's the number one reason why I'm visiting Gdansk.
Number 2, street arts.
So I'm in a place and it probably has the highest concentration of street arts in Europe. So if you know where I am, leave it in the comment below, otherwise I'll tell you. Maybe in a bit.
So this place is actually called Zaspa. There are more than 60 wall mirrors here in this one district. It all started in 1997, but it really exploded since 2009, and there are a lot of renowned international street art artists coming here to paint these walls. Look at that one. That guy's pretty cool, right? Wow, this one is really cool. That one's really funny. And there's a playground over there. I think this one is actually my favorite one because it's so simple and looks like a child's drawing. So it doesn't really belong here. Number 3. Abandoned buildings.
Right now, I'm in a place called Devil Hill here in Gdansk, and I'm going to visit a haunted mansion here.
So over there, that's it. That's a haunted mansion.
Behind me, it's the infamous haunted mansion of Gdansk. So this place, a very long time ago, it used to be a restaurant and also a residence. And after Second World War, it became a TV station, but now it has been abandoned for decades. So the legend goes, the previous owner of this place brought a devil stone from the hill behind me to the house, and ever since then the house became haunted. Well, not really a house, it's actually a mansion. This thing is gigantic. So unfortunately we cannot go in. I'll show you why. Okay, so they actually sealed off all the entrances with bricks because the building is really near the condition of collapse. And as you can see here through the window, inside is really collapsing. I saw some pictures online, and a couple of years ago some people went in and there were still floors and so on, but looking through this window, it's really not the condition you want to go in actually. So behind me here, it used to be the main entrance, but you can see over there, it's all sealed off by the fresh bricks to prevent people from getting inside and hurt themselves.
I'm in Gdansk Shipyard, and look around. These buildings, they are essentially ruins. You have broken glasses lying around all over the place. And check out this broken window here. We can creep into the abandoned building itself. Look. And right now I'm in Westerplatte, in the northern part of Gdansk, on the shore of the Baltic Sea. And there are a lot of ruins here. Let's go check it out. So this one is a new barrack. Let's go inside and check out how it looks like.
Thank you. Okay, I know this one. People will give me a hard time, especially certain Europeans, but in my defense, there's not really any bad invention, there are only bad users. And these are the top three reasons why I'm doing it. First, I just love the adrenaline rush. That moment in front of the lane. There's nothing comparable to that. And if you have never done it, you will never understand it. Secondly, it's just a tool and it's a sport. It's legal in many countries and it's even in the official Olympics games. Finally, God forbid if worst comes to worst. It would be so much more dangerous if it falls into the hands of someone who have no clue how to use it.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Closed. This pull back. Easy, yes, easy. Pull back. Okay, now stand at the one line. No, don't shoot. Very, very strong here. Fire. That's good. Okay.
Wow. That is crazy.
That is holy shit, yeah.
Holy that was amazing. Oh my god, those shotguns. I've never shot a shotgun before. But that is so powerful. Wow. Oh my god, so I shot like three different handguns, two rifles, including one AK, a shotgun, and in the end, yeah, check out the video, but I don't even know how to call that. And all this for 55 euros, so it's like $60.
Number 5, the food. So because of COVID, restaurants are unfortunately closed for dining in options. So I had to order through Uber Eats, but I've been to Poland before and I really love their dumplings. So I order dumplings again. Let's check it out. Side dish, kimchi. Oh, I don't know what this is. Dumplings. Very interesting to have soup in this kind of container. Let's try it. Soup smells super nice. It's really good. So this is a sausage. Super tasty.
This is my first real meal of the day. And the best thing about all this is everything here, in total, including delivery, costs around 55 Polish currency. So that is a little bit more than 10 euro.
Now, dumplings. This is what I've been waiting for.
So these are dumplings with wild boar.
Wow, see? Oh, this wild boar meat. Some sauce.
Let's try it out.
It's very interesting. It's nice.
Love Polish food.
And a bonus point for you guys, that is the price. Oh my god, everything compared to what I'm used to, it's just so much cheaper. Here is a breakdown of everything I spent during 30 hours.